We must revive the economy. We must revive the economy. We must create jobs for our young people in critical sectors, which include the present-day green and blue economies. We must deliver better services to our people. These are vital undertakings. Our success depends on our ability to work harder and smarter in unison and not in silos.
Cabinet members will be on retreat for 2 days, after which the president says will provide the executive the opportunity to prepare better for the next year and beyond. He says a big task lies ahead for them, given the outcome of the just concluded, tightly contested elections.
Let me remind you that as stated in the Cabinet Handbook, the success in administering and executing the functions of government depend on the work of the Cabinet and the support staff. With this in mind, I trust that as we enter the new year, you, together with your ministerial staff, will be able to deliver on the actions outlined in the second Harambe Prosperity Plan.
The COVID-19 pandemic forced cabinet and government at large to readjust what Geingob terms carefully laid out developmental plans this year. Resources had to be diverted to mitigate the impact of the pandemic, which included job losses and closure of businesses.
I have to say with humility that as a cabinet charged with the affairs of the state, we have done remarkably well. In our fight against the formidable enemy of COVID-19, which caused the death of 150 Namibians, we are way below the 4,000 COVID-19 related deaths which the World Health Organization had predicted. We have also been able to limit the envisaged severity of a negative knock-on impact on our economy through a timely rollout of an economic stimulus package.
Government is yet to determine the full extent of the impact of the coronavirus on the country's economy. Blanche Koreses, NBC News, Windhoek.